There was an idea to bring together a group of remarkable people to see if they could become something more. I wanted to try to explain why it seems like many players love this game, but YouTubers hate it. It's not just because of salt over exclusivity or their caution as it pertains to skin promotions. I can actually explain it in one word. Expectations. Many of the players already on board recognize the similarities to Destiny and embrace Marvel's Avengers as a spiritual successor to Marvel Ultimate Alliance or Marvel Heroes, or even Lego Marvel, depending on who you're talking to. But the YouTubers playing this game all want and expect the same thing. And that's a single-player focused experience potentially as fine-tuned as a God of War or a Spider-Man PS4. Is that what this game is? Hell no! Nor is it trying to be. And I challenge you to watch some of these hacks because many of them outright declare their preference for that to this. But this isn't a single-player focused game, and the truth of the matter is, if we were to assess Destiny by its story alone, dog shit is the only assessment many of us could come to. You play through a story mode once or twice maximum, if that based on statistics these days. But the endgame content is what you're expected to keep coming back for. Strikes, horde modes, raids, free roam activities, challenges, and the core gameplay is what's expected to hook people. And the gameplay, when it works, is fun and easy to enjoy. If this is the sandbox Crystal Dynamics plans to dump more Marvel characters into, some fans don't even need to hear anymore. But recognize this. Even if things may be working flawlessly for you, many people are experiencing crashes, stop motion frame rates, nauseating motion blurs, screen shakes, freezing, no FOV sliders, among other things, grant an experience in this sandbox that's like being stuck in quicksand. And no, recognition of these issues on a subreddit or on Twitter is not toxic or negative. Many of the most vocal people offering constructive criticism want this game to succeed more than you do. So say, for instance, you really don't care about emotes. If someone suggests an emote wheel so people can show off multiple emotes that they've unlocked or purchased, try not being a dick and saying, "Oh, well, the emote system's fine. Why are you saying it sucks?" I'm not saying it sucks. I'm saying it could be better. But if you immediately dismiss or downvote the suggestion, when it might actually incentivize people to spend and secure the longevity of this game, you're hurting yourself in confusion. And no disrespect to certain YouTubers with enough subs to be able to huff their own farts to mindless applause, but unlocking two abilities and calling this a button masher is inept. Getting to level 4 and saying the gear doesn't matter or aesthetically doesn't change on your character when you should know how no worthy looter is handing out good gear to a scrub, and that this game has modeled itself to sell skins to fund future DLCs. We can all agree that Crystal Dynamics has some serious optimization to work on between now and release, if that kind of miracle is even possible. But in the meantime, YouTubers could try being a little less IGN, and the players can stop downvoting any critique as if it's negativity. Play Avengers subreddit. If you make that place an echo chamber for only positive comments, you encourage the developers to overlook what matters, and you help to silently assassinate this community and this title. When I think about this game, I think potential. A Kamala Khan-centric story? It's the perfect starting place, definitely to iron out the kinks and get everything working before we potentially play through a Fantastic Four or an X-Men campaign. Crystal Dynamics, if you're listening, next week is your open beta. This will be the chance for all the non-pre-order folk who aren't already sipping the Kool-Aid to jump into the pool, see for themselves what's going on. For your sake, I hope everything runs smoothly. For our sake, communicate with us, and good luck. An emote wheel, allow us to lock gear to not accidentally delete it, and incorporate a switch character mode when we're taking pictures. Sometimes I can, if I could just get it from their angle, it'd be the best picture. My name's Kyle, and I apologize if I triggered anybody with anything in this video. It wasn't deliberate. If it was, I probably would have called Kamala Khan a less smart girl, Mr. Fantastic. I've actually been calling her Elastigirl. Okay, bye.